First, we're going to download everything we need. Download the latest release for Steam cmdgui.zip. On the MetaMod website, click Stable Builds on the left and click the big Windows button. Do the same thing on the SourceMod website. Download the latest kztimer version and choose the option that says Full. Finally, download the configs file in the description. Extract all the zip files. Open Steam CMDGUI. Click Download Steam CMD in the top right. This will create a Steam CMD zip file in your Steam CMD GIO folder. Extract it and move this resulting folder to your C drive or any other drive. I made a folder in a kztimer LAN in my D drive so I can easily find it. Back in the Steam CMD GUI, click Browser next to the Steam CMD path box. Choose the Steam CMD folder that you just created. Do the exact same thing for the server path box at the bottom. Click Update Install button and the command prompt will open. This is going to install your CSGO server and might take a while depending on your internet. When it's done, it will say success and you just close the window. Check your Steam CMDev folder and you'll see that the new folders and files were installed. Now we're going to install the MetaMod and SourceMod. Navigate through your Steam CMD folder like shown until you reach the folder named CSGO. Drag the contents of the MetaMod and SourceMod downloads into this folder. Click Yes to overwrite any files. Now we're going to drag and drop the contents of the kztimer download the same way. Kztimer is now fully installed, but we need to make some configuration changes before it will work. Go to the configs folder that you just downloaded and open admin-simple.ini in Notepad. Open the bottom line, you'll see my Steam ID, replace it with yours. To get your Steam ID, you just need a website like Steam ID Finder. Paste your Steam profile URL into the box, continue, and copy the first number. Place my Steam ID with yours, and then change the first 0 into a 1, if it isn't already. You can open the server CFG file and change the name on your LAN at the top, but it isn't necessary. In your server files, open the CFG folder and drag your server.cfg file in. Click back into the CSGO folder and then navigate through addons, sourcemod, and configs. Drag the admin simple and databases files here, say yes to replace them. Next, we need to put one KZ map into the server's map folder. This will be our default map. You can get a KZ map from the maps folder of your actual CSGO installation, or you can download one from the internet. I am using KZ Violet. Finally, we need to generate a web API authentic key. Go to the Steam Community Dev link in the description and click the link to the form. Agree to the terms of use and literally put anything you want into the domain name box. It doesn't matter. Copy the key, go to your server's CSGO folder and create a new text document. Name it web api authentic key.txt. Paste the key into the first line and save. Now we're done setting up the server's files and we can launch our server. Open Steam CMD GUI and click the Run Server tab. For the box, browse and choose your Counter-Strike dedicated server folder. Set the max players to 1, set your network to LAN. Set your default map to KZ map that you added in the previous steps. Click the plus button next to the run and paste the tickrate 128 command from the description. Press enter to confirm. Now we should save our settings so we don't have to repeat this in the future. Before we start our server, we have to launch CSGO first. Otherwise, it'll tell us that CSGO is already running. Once CSGO is open, click the Run button on Steam CMD GUI. In a few seconds, your server should be up and running. Open your Steam client, click View, and then Servers. You can use this to connect to your LAN server, and then save it to your favorites once you're in. Now we just need the global maps. Go to the description, find the link to the KZ global map collection. Use this command followed by the number in each workshop collection's URL. Make sure to do these one at a time. It'll probably take a while, so be patient. Usually your server will start to lag, which is a sign that it is working on downloading the maps. Once it's finished with the collection, it will automatically change the map. At this point, you move on to the next collection and repeat the process until you have all the global maps. Now our KZ LAN server is fully functional for general usage.